it is time to rebuild and reimagine the American waterways. This is a boat and it flies. I mean, that's the best way to describe it. Coastal cities are congested. In a year, a person spends about over 100 hours in traffic. But the waterways are this infrastructure, like already built out, that's just underutilized because we haven't figured out how to move things on the water at a cost-efficient way. And not only that, in a comfortable way. At Navier, we build a solution, the boat of the future, Navier 30. It is America's first all-electric hydrofoil boat. The world is going zero emission. The world is going electric. Boats are fundamentally inefficient. Why are you pushing water when you can actually glide over water? And suddenly, with hydrofoiling, the range is near about compatible to a traditional gas boat. If you can build cutting-edge technology that solves practical problems and can solve it today, that needs to be built. Hydrofoil basically means that this boat is half a boat and half a plane. This boat essentially has wings underwater.
You are literally flying on a cushion of air. If you look at just where populations grow, it's often around waterways. And those waterways separate people. They require bridges, traffic. So if you can have boats, you know, like here in San Francisco, cutting across the bay, that's great. The problem is San Francisco Bay, it's often choppy. Navier gets the boat up above all of that. You're cutting out all of that traffic, but you're doing it in a comfortable ride that's near silent and is energy efficient.
So you can reduce an hour and a half commute time to probably, in some cases, 15 minutes. And this 30-foot boat, it runs on a battery.
We're taking on electrifying boats. It's good for the environment. You aren't burning gasoline. You're also not putting oil into the water.
We're in a climate emergency. 60% of our emissions come from transportation. Transportation is the key to changing our carbon footprint. That's why boats like Navier are so important. Electrifying our ferries, using these smaller boats to get people to and from and across the bay, hopefully will encourage other communities to do the same.
You can feel how efficient it is. There's very little drag. That's one of the big reasons why it takes so much energy to propel a vessel through the water is you have all of that drag. When you lift the vessel hull up out of the water and have it operating on foils, you're going to have less drag. It's going to utilize less energy to be able to complete a trip. And that's good news for us because we're in the business of doing things the most efficient way possible.
So we have this wing that you can see right in the front of the boat. And so basically what happens is when you reach 16 knots, the wing in the front creates lift, and that lifts the whole boat 4 feet out of the water. And you'll notice the foil, it is up high right now, and that's because it's in its fully stowed position. And so you'll see as we deploy, this front foil is gonna go down in addition to the rear too, and then we can lift the boat 4 feet out of the water. So we'll be above the chop, above the waves, perfectly smooth, perfectly quiet. It feels like you're floating on clouds. You can put your coffee, your tea right on the sea in front of you, and it won't spill right as you're going through 2-3 foot chop at 30 miles an hour. We're able to rotate 360 degrees in place, as well as walk the boat perfectly side to side. So most people get very mad at each other when they're docking. It's a very stressful experience typically. But in this boat, you can be completely off center with your dock, and you can just walk sideways, you can spin, and then you can go right in.
Driving this boat is super easy. You're playing with a joystick and you're rotating in place, turning in place, going sideways. So this is where you have a map. And as I was saying, is this is a boat and it's a plane. So what you see here is actually what you would see in an aircraft flight control system. If every marina can be a transportation hub, more waterfront infrastructure developed, there's a whole new wave of economic activity, whole new wave of jobs, affordable housing. That is what is exciting. That is what inspires us to like get up and work as fast as we can to build out this vision.
When we see this sort of design combined with zero emission technology, like the battery electric system, it really gets us excited about the future for ferry service.
We've needed electric ferries and electric transportation on the waterfront for too long. It's amazing to see strong women pushing forward innovation.
Her leadership painting a picture that is kind of hard to imagine far off in the distance, and then getting a team to march towards that goal and actually delivering has been, for me, very inspirational.
Sometimes it's crazy to say that I want to build a transportation network for 46% of the world. The thing about building transportation is is just not about a startup. It's not just about a cool product. It's about a movement. It's about getting groups of people together who really care about building better cities. They care about humanity. They care about people living better lives, and they are biased to action. Let's make things happen now, because if not now, then when?